In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
We offer this Mass for the repose of soul of Dominic Lee. Brothers and sisters, let us call to mind our sins, so as to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done, in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask, Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Until the day when he was taken up to heaven, after giving instructions through the Holy Spirit to the apostles whom he had chosen. After his suffering, he presented himself alive to them by many convincing proofs, appearing to them during 40 days and speaking about the kingdom of God. While staying with them, he ordered them not to leave Jerusalem, but to wait there for the promise of the Father. This, he said, is what you have heard from me. For John baptized with water, but you will be baptized with the Holy Spirit not many days from now. So, when they had come together, they asked him, Lord, is this the time when you will restore the kingdom to Israel? He replied, it is not for you to know the times or periods that the Father has set by his own authority. But you will receive power when the Holy Spirit has come upon you, and you will be my witness in Jerusalem, in all Judea and Samaria and to the ends of the earth. When he had said this, as they were watching, he was lifted up, and a cloud took him out of their sight. While he was going, and they were gazing up towards heaven, suddenly two men in white robes stood by them. They said, "Men of Galilee, why do you stand looking up toward heaven? This Jesus, who has been taken up from you into heaven, will come in the same way as you saw him go into heaven." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. Brothers and sisters, I pray that the God of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of glory, may give you a spirit of wisdom and revelation as you come to know him, so that, with the eyes of your heart enlightened, you may know what is the hope to which he has called you, what are the riches of his glorious inheritance among the saints, and what is the immeasurable greatness of his power. For us who believe according to the working of his great power, God put this power to work in Christ when he raised him from the dead and seated him at his right hand in the heavenly places, far above all rule and authority and power and dominion, and above every name that is named, not only in this age, but also in the age to come. And he has put all things under his feet and has made him the head over all things for the church, which is his body, the fullness of him who fills all in all. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to the disciples, These are my words that I spoke to you while I was still with you, that everything written about me in the law of Moses, the prophets, and the Psalms must be fulfilled. Then he opened their minds to understand the scripture, and he said to them, Thus it is written that the Christ is to suffer and to rise from the dead on the third day, and that repentance and forgiveness of sins is to be proclaimed in his name to all nations, beginning from Jerusalem. You are witnesses of these things. And see, I'm sending upon you what my Father promised. So stay here in this city until you have been clothed with power from on high. Then he led them out as far as Bethany, and lifting up his hands, he blessed them. While he was blessing them, he withdrew from them and was carried up into heaven. And they worshipped him and returned to Jerusalem with great joy. And they were continually in the temple, blessing God. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Today the Church celebrates the Ascension of the Lord. When we think of the Ascension of the Lord, we kind of think of farewell, Jesus leaving us. But I can assure you that this ascension is not Jesus' departure in the sense of Jesus leaving us, as if he were abandoning us. As we know for a fact that Jesus, the Prince of Peace, God with us, is still with us. Not in the same way that Jesus used to journey on the earth with his disciples, proclaiming the good news, performing miracles, and those are the things that he used to do, he's no longer doing. But having, you know, rose from the dead and then ascended into heaven, he is with us in the spiritual sense, in the sense that God is with us as we are gathered. God is present among us. So now, for us to see Jesus, it requires our faith to be able to see. When we come to the Eucharist, it requires faith for us to recognize Jesus. To a certain extent, what God is trying to do is God is trying to spread the gift of our faith so that we will increase in the gift of faith and for the world to come to believe and the world will come to trust in God and increase in their faith through the work of a mission that we are called to do. So the mission that Jesus did, God wants us to continue. So there's a story told of this, I'm sure, you know, Leonardo da Vinci requires no introduction. So one day, Leonardo da Vinci was working on a large canvas. He carefully, you know, picked out what kind of scene that he wanted to paint. And then he started to sketch, you know, studying the perspective. And after he finished sketching, now he was applying the colors. And almost towards the end of his, you know, working on the canvas, and nearing the completion, he stopped working on it. And his disciples were scratching their heads, thinking, why did our teacher just stop? You know, he should have finished this project. And then one day, Leonardo da Vinci actually called one of his favorite students and said, do you see this? I would like you to finish what I started. And he was completely horrified. He said, well, what do you mean? Like, this is such a masterpiece. There's no way I can touch your work. And he goes, no, think about this. After everything that I have done, would not what I have done inspire you to do your very best? And he was actually very, very touched and inspired. He actually finished that painting. And that painting is now known as the Ascension of the Lord. Because that's what Jesus is asking us to do. He wants us to continue the mission that he started. But we don't have to reinvent our faith and the way we do evangelization. We can just do what Jesus did. And the way we go about doing that is exactly like, you know, when you go to IKEA, you go to IKEA, you pick out exactly what you want, you put it in your car, you come home, you take everything out of the box, you look at the instruction, and you realize everything is there. The manufacturer made everything, it came with the instruction, left your contribution out, so all you have to do is just put it together. In a sense, the mission of the church is exactly like that. The mission that Jesus started, that God wants us to bring to completion, each and every of our lives requires that. We have to do our part. We have to make our contribution. So to preach the good news about the gift of God's love. And the gift of God's love and God's forgiveness is exactly the reason for our hope. So whatever the work of evangelization and forgiveness of love that you and I have left unfinished so far, let us go home today. Let us return to our lives and complete that work of the church, work of Jesus Christ, in spreading the good news, spreading the love and forgiveness. Let us now stand and profess our faith together. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, who was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. When our risen Savior ascended into heaven, angels reminded his disciples that he would come back again. Until he comes, we continue his work by praying for all peoples and their needs.
That the church on earth will ever keep to its evangelical mission of making disciples of all nations. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the leaders of the world may realize that they must give an account of their work to Jesus Christ when he returns as our judge. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
That no one will be so attached to this earth as to regret being called to eternal life in heaven. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
That we may all come to the maturity of faith in the fullness of the risen Christ. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
As violence spread across Ukraine, we may pray that world leaders may focus on the good of all people by advancing peace rather than descending further into war. May God comfort the Ukrainian people who are suffering, distressed, and grieving, and may he welcome the faithful departed into his kingdom. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For our sick, especially Maria Mariano, Lisa Petriglia, Donato Pica, Leah Messina, Lily DiCarlo, Catherine Thompson, Mary Vatour, Julian Call, Peter Fasulo, Joe Pritchard, Margaret Booney, Natir Aziz, Larry Gower, Mario Bucci, Rosaria Chiesa, Ivana and Freddie Santini, Rose Romano, Rosalba Massara, Stella Carella Campolucci, Crystal Sunday, Sami Bashraktari, Maria Mariani, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all our dead may ascend to glory with Christ, our priest and king, especially Dominic Lee, Husbert Wilson, Vincent Chuvantu, Anna Trentinat, and Stephen Sayed. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
God, our Father in heaven, your Son is now seated at your right hand, enthroned in eternal glory. We make our petitions through him, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. O God, whose only begotten Son, our High Priest, is seated ever living at your right hand to intercede for us, grant that we may approach with confidence the throne of grace and there obtain your mercy. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For the Lord Jesus, the King of glory, conqueror of sin and death, ascended today the highest heavens, as the angels gazed in wonder, mediator between God and man, judge of the world, and Lord of hosts, he ascended not to distance himself from our lowly state, but that we, his members, might be confident of following where he, our head and founder, has gone before. Therefore, overcoming paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise. And even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death,
O Lord,
and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Thomas, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember your servant Dominic, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that he, who was united with your Son in a death like his, may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done,
on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you all. Let us offer each other the sign. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, have mercy on me, and I am weary, for I am only
May the gifts we have received from your altar, Lord, kindle in our hearts a longing for the heavenly homeland, and cause us to press forward, following in the Savior's footsteps, to the place where for our sake he entered before us, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow your heads and pray for God's blessings. May Almighty God bless you, for on this very day his only begotten Son pierced the heights of heaven, and unlocked for you the way to ascend to where he is. Amen. May he grant that as Christ, after his resurrection, was seen plainly by his disciples, so when he comes as judge, he may show himself merciful to you for all eternity.
Amen.
And may you who believe he is seated with the Father in his majesty know with joy the fulfillment of his promise to stay with you until the end of time.
Amen.
May the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit come Amen. Down on you and remain with you forever and ever.
Amen.
Go in peace.
Thanks be to God.
St. Michael the Archangel, be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him with humble prayer. And do thou, Prince of the heavenly host, by the power of God, cast to hell Satan and all the evil spirits who prowl about the world, seeking the ruin of souls.
Amen.
Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.